Continuing coverage of the public hearing for a proposed casino near Gettysburg. The hearing is in its second day with hundreds of supporters and opponents making their cases. News 8's Ed Weinstock has been following the hearing since it began yesterday, and he is live with an update. Good afternoon, Ed.
Hello, Susan. If you remember how crowded the parking lot of the Comfort Suites was yesterday, if you look across the street now, you'll see that there's a lot fewer cars out there. After hearing the testimony of some 300 people, the hearing is now winding down. It's expected to wrap up sometime this afternoon. As of an hour ago, there was only about 80 people still on the speaker's list. Witnesses are sworn in before they speak. These are individuals who are expressing their personal views on why or why not a casino should be built in Cumberland Township outside Gettysburg. The Eisenhower Hotel and Conference Center would be converted into a casino resort. It would have hundreds of slot machines and 50 table games.
A new casino would provide good paying jobs for area residents who are struggling through a difficult economic time.
The casino is not in harmony with and would detract from the unique historical identity that Gettysburg means to people across the United States.
I believe that the Mason-Dixon proposal cheapens the memory of what Gettysburg is world famous for and exploits a national treasure.
I'm all for the casino, and I really hope that you guys would take into consideration, you know, everybody buys a lottery ticket, it's a gamble.
Gettysburg businessman David Levan, the principal investor, has been here for the 2 days of the hearings, the state gaming control hearings going on right now at the hotel behind me. Now, it is expected that the State Gaming Control Board will make a decision on whether Gettysburg will get a casino or not get a casino sometime before the end of this year. That's the story from here. Back to you, Susan.
All right, Ed.